Here's what we know. Last February, a 49-year-old woman filed a report with New South Wales Police alleging she was raped more than 30 years ago by a man who is now a frontbencher. In late June of last year, the complainant told police she didn't want to go ahead with the investigation. The following day, she took her own life. 2 days ago, the Prime Minister, Penny Wong and Sarah Hanson-Young all received the allegations in an anonymous letter, which they then passed on to police.
The Prime Minister must confirm to himself that the minister, who's the subject of these allegations, that it's appropriate for him to stay in his current position.
This afternoon, former PM Malcolm Turnbull revealed he too received a letter from the alleged victim back in December 2019.
She described a pretty horrific rape that she said had occurred in the hands of this person. I think there clearly needs to be some form of inquest.
What we don't know is how the PM is planning to respond.
His silence so far is deafening.
With growing calls for the minister involved to identify himself and stand down.
The Prime Minister should be standing this minister aside while the Prime Minister works out whether or not there's a spot in his cabinet for someone with such a serious and unresolved accusation hanging over their head.
The AFP Commissioner was very, very clear that these are matters for police and strongly discouraged commentary on those matters.
It all comes as Rochelle Miller, the former staffer who accused two government ministers of bullying and intimidation, launches legal action against them.
Clearly, women are subject to stereotypes, ridiculous stereotypes, but also sexism and harassment. That's an unacceptable culture and it has to change. I hope this is a watershed moment, I really do.
So with Canberra already in crisis over its handling of the Brittany Higgins allegations, have we finally reached the tipping point for a reckoning?
Well, Guardian's Amy Remikas joins us now. Amy, this is a government in crisis. Do you think the PM is banking on the fact that with the victim now deceased and little evidence to go on, as far as we know, this will all just eventually fade away?
Well, we do know that the Prime Minister and everyone else who has spoken on this terrible issue do keep pointing to the police investigation. And as you point out, that police investigation died when the victim did. So it's a very difficult one to try and bat away. But the bigger issue here is transparency and how the government is going to react. These are heinous allegations and the public needs to know that the government is going to be transparent and is going to be open about getting to the bottom of this.
Well, saying that, the allegation is really hanging over all cabinet ministers of a certain age. How much pressure do you think there'll be for the alleged perpetrator to reveal himself from these other people?
I think there will be a lot of pressure because this isn't something that's going to weigh. This is not something you can talk about happening just in the parliament bubble. This isn't something that you can just sort of say, we're not going to answer questions on this, because people want answers. They want to know what has happened, what is going to happen, and who is taking any sort of responsibility for guiding people through this. I think you're going to see a lot of people asking a lot of very uncomfortable questions in the next couple of weeks and not necessarily getting the answers, which of course is going to do nothing for the public as it looks for leadership in this.
Amy, thanks very much for your time this evening.
Thank you.
There's little doubt, Heather, this is a very difficult situation in terms of what can and can't be reported. But one thing that I think everyone can agree on is that the police need to do whatever they can do as quickly as they possibly can so that we can at least have some clarity on that front before whatever plays out beyond that.
Yeah, absolutely.
From expert opinions to in-depth analysis and reporting, the Project YouTube brings you the biggest stories from Australia and around the globe. Hit the subscribe button now for news delivered straight to your feed.